So towards the end of last year, as well as early this year, I was approached to be a marketing consultant for an aircon company. The reason why is because this aircon company wants to have a new era of growth. And they feel their brand has been stagnant for some time, and they want to find a way, a marketing process that will upgrade their brand, at the same time give them more sales. Me being a passionate marketer as well, I took this as an opportunity to have fun. And what I did was I think up a very, very smart idea and a proposal on how they can improve their brand at the same time increase their sales via a very smart servicing program. So what I did was I went to the company and I gave a presentation on what I'm going to do to the company. So initially, they liked my idea, but they thought I was too young and I don't have enough experience. But after a few months, they actually called me in again to listen further on my idea. And what I did was I prepared a detailed presentation on this idea and I shared it with them. This includes what's the scheme about, how we are gonna do it, and how the profit will come about, and how this will improve their brand. Everything. And they asked me for a price. And me being so occupied with so many things, I've given a high price, because if you want me to do this, I love generating ideas, but to implement it is so difficult. I would like to charge a high price if you want me to implement it. Turns out they say that my marketing is the most expensive, which was funny to me, because what's expensive? Expensive is if I spend this money and create no result, then it's expensive. But if every dollar I spend for you, I make you $10 back, is it expensive? So anyway, they said I was the most expensive marketer and they rejected my bid. So, and I thought, okay, it's a fun experience. But after a few months, and only recently, I saw on Facebook, they were running an ad, and in that ad, they were using my idea. And I press in and I look at the scheme. Even what they say in the video is exactly what I told them. So in other words, they took my idea and implemented it on their own without even telling me, even though they promised they will not steal my idea without letting me know. Even though they promised in the meeting that they will not steal my idea without hiring me. So what am I trying to tell you here? Actually, what am I trying to tell you here is very simple. I don't mind that much. Actually, I look at it as a fun experience and a confidence boost, because my idea was so good that people want to use it. I was just sad the way Malaysians do business is so unethical and not professional. I actually don't mind if they tell me, right? Because to give the idea is easy, to implement it is so hard, right? Ideas are cheap, implementation is the expensive part. But then it's sort of like without my blessing. So anyway, this is an example of how a potentially bad situation can be turned into something which is a good situation. Somebody steal my idea, but I turn it into my idea, got confirmation. Hey, therefore I have some worth as a marketer, right? So in the end of the day, my mood actually improved a little bit because of this. There's a message I want to share with you. Whatever situation that happened, there's always a way for you to turn it into a happy situation. Hope this message will brighten up your day if you're having this kind of issue as well. Bye.